Dames en heren, goedenavond.
Goedemorgen, goedenacht. U heeft een hele goede keus gedaan, vind ik, want we gaan inderdaad straks luisteren naar het Wynton Marsalis Quintet. U kent hopelijk de geschiedenis, de zeer jonge geschiedenis van de trompetist. Hij komt uit New Orleans, net zoals zijn broer. En de andere broers die nog niet eens platen gemaakt hebben, maar er ook aan zitten te komen. Wynton Marsalis heeft inmiddels zijn eerste plaat gemaakt die als een bom insloeg. Niet alleen in Amerika, maar ook in Europa. En er komt een tweede aan die, en dat is ook zijn liefde, niet alleen de jazzmuziek, maar ook de klassieke muziek. En die tweede plaat inderdaad zal over trompetconcerten gaan van onder andere Hummel en Haydn, geloof ik. Dat zullen we vanavond niet horen. Ik stel u graag voor aan de leden van het quintet. Dat is allereerst op slagwerk Jeff Watts. Jeff Watts. Een zeer talentrijk bassist ook. Dat is Phil Bowler. Phil Bowler is de bassist. Op piano, Kenny Kirkland. Kenny Kirkland. Broer Branford, die speelt vanavond tenorsaxofoon en ook sopraan. Branford Marsalis. En de man uiteraard waar het in principe om draait, de leider. 20 jaar is hij al. Wynton Marsalis. Wynton Marsalis.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. thank all of you for coming out and supporting us this evening. Thank you all very much. On the piano, Mr. Kenny Kirkland. Kenny Kirkland. On the bass, Mr. Phil Bowler. On the drums, Mr. Jeff Watts. On the saxophone, Mr. Branford Marsalis. And yours truly, Wynton Marsalis on trumpet. Thank you and good night.
Dames en heren, de Wynton Marsalis Quintet. De Wynton Marsalis Quintet. En hartelijk dank voor uw komst hier naar de PBA-zaal. Ik meld u dat we om half drie, ongeveer half drie beter gezegd, verder gaan met het concert van het Keeslinger Octet en John Hendricks and Company. Dank u wel voor de aandacht.
Hallo Dijn. Staat hij open? Hallo. Staat hij open? Oké. Okay. Loopt de Ampex tegen hem?
Wynton Marsalis, 20 years old, New Orleans. Father Ellis, he taught you a lot.
Yes, he did. Beginning of the lines. Zo, nou prima.
Data. Kom.
Oké.
Wynton Marsalis, 20 years old, New Orleans. Your father, Ellis, taught you a lot, I said.
Yes, he did.
Not only the family members?
Well, you know, no, he's talking to a lot of guys at the New Orleans Center for Creative Arts. The guys who play with Art Blakey now, Terrence Blanchard and Donald Harrison. They study with my father and my brother, you know. A lot of other guys coming up, younger cats.
All from New Orleans, right?
All from New Orleans. All.
Well, not all, but a lot of them.
I mean, the cats that he did studied under him are all from New Orleans.
Okay, yeah, you got me there. What I would like to know is how will everything develop? How much time will it take before you say, okay, I reached a point now where everything I play is entirely my own?
I might not ever get to that. Nobody has ever gotten to that.
Why not?
No musician that I've ever heard that I think didn't have elements that can be found in other players' influence, other players playing the players that influenced them.
Yeah, but the influence after 1 year or after 10 years will be gone at a certain point of the game. No?
No, never. It's never gone. It just takes on a more personal thing. You know, everything is already in the music.
Yeah, but if it gets that personal, is my point, then people will not even refer to other players that were the influence.
That's true. If once you do enough records and they get used to your sound.
Right, yeah. So I have to know a little more about all those family members that are coming up still.
Well, no, I have a little younger brother that plays trombone.
How old is he?
He's 16 now. So maybe he'll pursue music, but that's all. I have a little brother that's 5, you know, he's interested in music.
I heard a little about the 5-year-old brother. He's going to be the genius, Branford told me.
He has perfect pitch and stuff, yeah. He's ridiculous.
And his preference is the drums, right?
He likes drums, yeah.
But also other instruments, also reed instruments.
He likes everything. He's just 5, you know. He might not even be a musician. He might become an engineer or something.
That would be a shame, maybe, for the world.
I don't know.
What will the next record be about? Because I heard that the second one will be a classical record, right?
Right, I have to do a classical record, and then I'm going to do a jazz record. I don't know, the next one will probably be more, the music will be more complex than the music on the first one. Be more parts.
The quintet, you mean?
More different. Be much more difficult to play the music.
And the classical record will consist of music?
Hummel trumpet concerto and Tomasi trumpet concerto.
Tomasi, beautiful. So after this festival year, do you really have an idea about the whole setup of this festival? I mean, you know, 10 rooms to play under one roof?
It's big. It's good. You know, it's good to have large festivals like this. It gives publicity to music.
Do you know at what festival you just played?
Nazi.
Okay. Well, you know, it's a matter for a lot of musicians about getting in from the airport into the hotel, on stage and back to the hotel and to the airport.
That's how it is.
Isn't that, that's not what you really wanted in the first place?
No, but that's part of it. You get used to it.
It's also a seasonal thing.
Sure. Every summer.
So what do you do in the wintertime?
Same thing.
But festivals?
We play in clubs, you know, we play clubs in the wintertime. At home, if they have enough clubs open for us to travel. It's bad, the scene is pretty bad right along through here.
You really have to make the money during the summer for the whole year?
Well, if you can make it, yes. But it's not really a lot of money in this. I mean, for the musicians, the promoters and, you know, video people. They sell all these videos.
They take too much away from you.
We don't get any money.
But you're not doing so bad.
Doing all right. I mean, I'm not doing as good as some people who are making money off of what I'm playing.
I mean, for a guy your age, you're making good money for all the talent that you got. You're worth it.
Yeah, but you know what I'm saying. If it's your product, you know, what is enough?
Yeah, okay. Thank you a lot, Wynton Marsalis.
Thank you.